Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Before we begin, I'd like to give a huge thank you to everyone for subscribing. It really means a lot to me that there are a thousand of you who genuinely enjoy my content and have subscribed to the channel. Before we begin, I'd like to make a couple of announcements. As you may have seen, I haven't been uploading nearly as often as I used to. I've been terribly busy with schoolwork and projects, and a lack of motivation has really shut me down in regard to recording trades videos. So therefore, I'm going to be putting the Ruckhound project on the back burner for the time being. So, let's get into the questions now, shall we? This first question comes from at iSupportTrains999. What's your favorite gen of K5 HLA? What's your favorite K5 LLA? And what's your favorite K5 HL? I'm going to say I don't like the K5 HLA and the K5 HL, but I do like the K5 LLA. And I like the ones on the Union Pacific SC78s Tier 4s. Those are really nice. Best CSX-8-9, I would say the ones in the YN2 scheme. Hands down, great scheme, honestly. And do I like the AC44NCW? Yes, I like it a lot better than the ES44 AC and the ET44 AC because it's just a lot less mundane. It was like the last GE locomotive before the GVO Prime Mover. And yeah, they're actually just really cool looking diesels. I like the sounds they make, like the horns they have. So all around, pretty great locomotive. This question comes from at Model Routing with Evan ST 2014. Would I ever do a trains railfanning video of Dallas Fort Worth in the 60s? That would be actually a really fun idea. Only problem is that that's a lot of work. I'd have to create an entirely new route depicting Dallas Fort Worth in the 60s. Not a lot of information available on that. I mean, I do have a diagram of Union Terminal back in the 40s, which could help, but that would be very limiting on what I could actually do. I'd just focus around the downtown area. But it would be a really fun idea to try if anybody ever released a route in that area, or there is a route that looked a lot like the area that Dallas Fort Worth is in. I would love to do that, but not right now. I cannot do that. But thank you for the suggestion, though. Third question comes from at Traincraft Fan. If the Rockhound did not go bankrupt, what would be its fate during the 80s and 90s railroad mergers? And if it survived, what would its modern livery be? I feel like it would still would have been merged in the 90s. Honestly, because Union Pacific probably would have grabbed them up, or it would have been left to die, because the lines are pretty similar between UP and BNSF. The Ruckhound had a bunch of redundant trackage when it came to the Union Pacific, so it probably wouldn't be of very much use. It didn't survive because the trustee said, you know, they wanted to liquidate everything, even though they were about to break even, so it's just a cruel world of how railroads work, I guess. If it survived, I would say Bankruptcy Blue would remain the current livery because it's just actually really modern compared to the old livery. Even the speed lettering livery was pretty modern, but the old liveries were not as modern. So I feel like Bankruptcy Blue would be the way to go forward. This question comes from at the Oklahoma Hot Rail. What are my thoughts on the UP Pratt sub? Well, I know it's in Oklahoma, I know it's around the Panhandle area, but I've never been up there. I think, based on your videos, it looks like a pretty good place to see trains. Wide open area, trains go fast there, so I might come up and visit sometime to have a look around, look at the action. So, I might go up there sometime, but I currently don't have any opinions on it because I've never been there. So, yeah, it'd be a pretty cool place to go to. At NTYTP asks, what is my honest opinion on the Silver Line? The Silver Line is going to revolutionize transit in Dallas, especially North Dallas, who's needed transit, rail transit for a long time. It's going to speed up commuting time to the airport a lot. It's going to speed up time to Fort Worth a lot. You don't have to go through downtown anymore. You won't take the Orange Line up and waste a bunch of time. And it's going to be safer, so, and faster, most likely. So it'll be a major revolution for rail transportation up there, and just transit in general. Public transportation is something Dallas needs so bad. I cannot stress enough how much we need to get away from car dependency and switch to more transit solutions, more biking, more walking. That'll do a lot of good for Texas and Dallas. That'll do a lot of good for the environment and a lot of good for humanity as a whole. If we switch to more less car dependent cities, more 15-minute cities, walkability, bikeability, transit-oriented development, it'll be great. Can't wait for the Silver Line to be done. It should be so cool. Honestly, I've seen the updates on the project recently. I've actually been able to go out there and look at it. It's been pretty good, pretty cool. And what's 2-10 to 25? I don't know what that is, or just as clueless as I am, so thank you. At MattyPad777 asks, I have three questions. What would happen if the New York Central Railroad never merged with the Pennsylvania Railroad existed today? I would honestly say they'd probably merge anyway after 1970s and that whole economic time. It just seems inevitable that ever-increasing competition means they'd probably merge with somebody and then get merged up later on after Stagger's Act passed. So, yeah. What if the Reading Railroad never went bankrupt? I think it would also have been merged up into other railroads. Pennsylvania Railroad, New York Central Railroad. If Pennsylvania Railroad and New York Central had merged, probably would have been absorbed by Conrail as well. If it had survived, I don't think it would have much of a future amongst Norfolk Southern, CSX. It would need its own little niche to carve out, and I don't think it would have that. And what if New York Central J3A 5443 was never scrapped and was donated to the New Northern? I would say, honestly, it would be a boom for New York Central fans and steam fans all over the world. Honestly, New York Central doesn't have really any preserved locomotives thanks to Perelman and his policies. So if one of them got preserved, that would be awesome, especially the J3A Hudson. I mean, those are beautiful looking locomotives, pulled 20th Century Limited. So, honestly, it would have been a really good deal for rail fans, steam preservation fans, and New York Central fans around the world. So, at HotJammy1696 asks, have you ever thought of asking a dart driver to depart at slow speed? I have not. I haven't really found much of a use for it. Honestly, I haven't really had a need to record the sound of the inverters. So, I don't think I ever will, but it'd be really cool to at least get an audio sample sometime, so maybe someday I'll ask him, but I don't think I will now. At Chefanonash 3418 asks, what do you prefer, SC70 Mac or the AC4400CW? Honestly, I prefer the SC70 Mac. It's a lot more unique looking, and even amongst EMDs, it's a lot more unique compared to the AC4400. GE kind of used the same car body design since the Dash 8 all the way up to the ET44. Same cab. There's a few additions to the long hood, but other than that, stayed pretty similar. The EMD SC70 series changed a lot over the course of its production run, and I think it honestly looks a lot cooler, so I'm going to go with the SC70 Mac. At Iron Horse Media 2881 asks, a fallen flag I wish was still around. Probably Rock Island, MKT, Mopac, very influential railroads in Texas, lots of history, lots of interesting things. Rock Island had a crazy power roster, MKT was a really interesting railroad, cool paint scheme, and the Mopac had a bunch of cool things going on, interesting history, interesting paint scheme, all blue was crazy. I guess it saves a lot of money though. But yeah, I'd like to see those three railroads around. Be really cool to see them in action, especially in the modern day, but I don't think they would have survived past the 90s, honestly. At DFWRF asks, do you plan on going to Trinity Lake Station, and how do I feel about Richland Hill Station closing? Trinity Lakes, I've actually wanted to go there for a while now. I got to see it once over when I passed over it on the interstate. Pretty cool looking, honestly. I'd love to go there. It looks great. Can't wait for the TOD developments. And a little sad about Richland Hill Station closing, but it didn't really serve much of a purpose. No TOD, it was kind of just a parking lot. I guess it served the neighborhoods around it, but other than that, it wasn't that useful. I guess it will be a cool place to go railfanning still, but a lot harder to access now that you can't get to it by train. I've seen a couple videos of people sitting on the platform as trains go by. It's pretty cool, but I don't think you're allowed to be on the station platform anymore because it's now not supposed to be being used. It's going to be demolished here soon, so yeah. I think I might visit it in the future, but not now. At Gabriel Arambula 4465 asks, favorite era of the Southern Pacific and or Santa Fe? Have to say around the late 70s, early 80s, just before SPSF. Honestly, really great time for railroading as a whole. Lots of interesting power mingling with newer power, GB50s, and the like, mingling with GB30s, GB40s, and you got the B-23-7, B-30-7, U-boats, all the different kinds, SD-45s, F-45s, I mean, it's just a great time. I would have loved to see those two railroads running back then. Obviously, I couldn't have, but it would be really cool if I could have. So yeah, I have to say early, late 70s, early 80s. Last but not least, at Trains20 asks, what's my favorite YouTube video I've ever made? I'd probably have to say my Santa Fe pacing video. I forgot the title, but it was a recreation of an old Railfan classic video of this guy pacing a Santa Fe hotshot train on Tatchby's on Mojave Subdivision back in the 90s. It was just really cool. I had a really fun time remaking that, getting down to 4x3, putting over the filters, and doing the editing. I've had the idea for a while, and I just thought, why not act on it? So, yeah. Thank you all for your questions and comments over the years. I really appreciate them all. Appreciate the Q&A questions, every single one of them. Even though there was a bunch, I still had lots of fun seeing comments and thinking of responses to them. So, thank you a lot. Thank you for 1,000 subscribers, actually. And Road to 2,000. I kind of want to talk about monetization a little bit. I still have to get 4,000 public watch hours, and that's a little bit far off. But when I do, I don't think I'm going to monetize immediately. I'm going to do a poll asking if y'all want to monetize the channel or not. And if it goes through, then I'll start making money off my videos. I know you guys don't like ads. I don't like ads. So I just want to gauge y'all's opinion before I do something of that caliber. Because I'm just here for fun. I just want to do this for fun. Money is just a secondary part of it. I want to make content that I would enjoy, that you would enjoy. And I think everybody should be doing this. YouTube shouldn't just be for money. It should be for your own enjoyment. So that's my opinion. So thank you very much for watching. Thanks so much for submitting your questions and all the support you've given me over the past 6 years. I really appreciate it, every single one of you. This is DFW Rail Videos out.